among all the diverse GABAergic interneuron subtypes, Chandelier cells, also referred to as exoaxonic cells, are arguably the most distinctive one. So this unique morphology or structure of the Chandelier cell allows it to make contact with a wide variety of neighboring pyramidal neurons. Moreover, and importantly, unlike other interneuron subtypes, Chandelier cells selectively innervate the axon initial segment, which is labeled in blue here, of pyramidal neuron, which is the most excitable part of the neuron where action potential is initiated. So combined, those characteristics make a Chandelier cell ideally suited to exert powerful control over the output of the neighboring pyramidal neurons. Furthermore, the importance of Chandelier cell function is highlighted by an association between Chandelier cell connectivity defects and brain disorders such as schizophrenia, epilepsy, and autism spectrum disorders. Now, despite the importance of normal Chandelier cell function, till date, virtually nothing is known about the mechanisms that govern this unique subcellular innervation of pyramidal neuron AISs by Chandelier cells. To identify molecular factors important for this process, Yilin Tai and Nicholas Gallo in the lab developed a strategy or a method that allows us to manipulate, on one hand, the adhesion molecules located at the AIS and axon, and simultaneously label the Chandelier cells so that the contact between these two neuron types could be evaluated. Now, remarkably, of all the molecules we screened, only the PyNs-only adhesion molecule L1 CAMP emerged to be critical for the innervation of the pyramidal AIS by Chandelier cells, because silencing or depleting L1 CAMP in the pyramidal neuron resulted in a marked decrease of Chandelier cell cartridge innervation at the structure of the AIS.
So these connections, you can almost imagine it as something like Velcro, whereas you have, on one side, you have these little hooks as Velcro, and then you also have, on the other side, you have like felt, and they latch together and they help to form the connections between two things. And so in this analogy, you could think of L1 CAM being almost the hooks. They will latch onto the Chandelier cell cartridge, the part that forms these synapses. And so this is the first time this has ever been shown.
So after we uncovered that L1 CAM plays a critical role in the establishment of innervation, we wanted to know whether it also plays a role in the maintenance of this process to keep the Chandelier cell and the pyramidal neuron together. And to do so, we depleted L1 CAM at postnatal day P28, that is when all the connections have already been formed, to see whether that would affect the percentage of innervation. And so, intriguingly, when we silenced or depleted L1 CAMP in the pyramidal neuron at postnatal day P28, we indeed observed a significant decrease in the percentage of AISs innervated by the Chandelier cells, indicating that L1 CAMP plays a dual role, not only in the establishment of innervation, but also in their maintenance, thus to keep them together, of the Chandelier cells and the pyramidal neurons.